Although the proposed budget for the Ministry of Education and Sports has increased from 3.9 trillion shillings to 4.5 trillion shillings in the financial year 2023-2024, budgets for 18 voters and subventions under the ministry have suffered huge budget cuts to the tune of 80%.
Yes, we want really to appreciate the government that they have thought about the education sector under the Human Resource Capital Development Program. We've gotten provision for an increment in the budget for the coming financial year, but this increment is mainly to take care of the salaries of teachers.
While presenting a report for the 2023-2024 budget framework paper for agencies in the education sector to the Budget Committee of Parliament, the Vice Chairperson of the Education Committee, Cuthbert Abigaba, urged the Budget Committee to find money for the arts teachers in secondary schools and primary teachers before they go for another sit-down strike.
We had this recommendation even last year. So we reiterate that funding for the arts teachers in secondary schools and primary school teachers be considered in the financial year 2023-2024 budgetary allocations. Honorable Chair and members, this is a very, very hot matter.
I'm also interested in the issue of salaries. I think it's my humble prayer, as the committee has also submitted, that we harmonize the issue of salaries. These discrepancies are the ones that brought even issues in some entities of government. You find UNRWA getting a lot of money, government agencies getting different salaries, so we should harmonize to have our colleagues, you know, at the nearly the same level.
The Minister of Education wants Parliament to reverse the proposed budget cuts in the education sector amounting to 170.95 billion shillings, which have affected critical items in the sector, including the students' loan scheme, sports, among others.
Chair, in summary, the subventions which have suffered 80% cut, the total cut, which is in Annex 1 of the report, totals to 170.95 billion shillings. And Chair, I would pray that this cut is reversed by the Minister of Finance, Planning and Economic Development, as will be highlighted in our recommendations.
On top of the budget cuts, the ministry is grappling with a huge funding gap of 774 billion shillings due to key unfunded priorities. These include grant aiding of schools, which has a shortfall of 34 billion shillings. 620 schools across the country are requested for government takeover, but the ministry has no money.
Much as the budget has increased, but a number of votes, 18 of them, have had their budgets reduced. And Chair, all subventions which are within our ministry have suffered an 80% budget cut on their non-wage expenditure.
However, budget committee members have called for realignment of the budget for the education sector to find money for the key strategic unfunded priorities of the sector.
The issue of grant aid, Chair, but we need to know the performance of this financial year. Maybe as you come towards the ministerial, you need to give us a list of what has been done, the status, so that we can be able to see what there is to do.
But the money going to federation is called subvention. But inside that subvention includes money that under normal circumstances is paying Ugandans who are doing a piece of work for Uganda. Athletes are paid, coaches are paid. But when we are cutting, we call it subvention 80% cut. Now when you see the proposal, 30 billion cut.
Legislators have also proposed reforms in the policy on government scholarships to benefit needy children. MPs contend that government scholarships and the students' loan scheme benefit children of the rich who can afford elite class schools around Kampala and Wakiso.
Honorable Chair, there is a big problem in the country in that those who qualify to go for government scholarships are those who have money, who can actually pay their primary education in good primary school, and they go in secondary education in good secondary school, and they end up getting the government sponsorship. And they are the same people who are given resources, while others who do not have the opportunity, they study in the USE schools and UPE schools. fail to get the government.
And government sponsorships, I think it is also covered. We've made a very serious recommendation here that all sponsorships and the loan scheme, they need to be consolidated and all put under the loan scheme arrangement.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.